Hi friends, continuing on with the mathematical expectation problems, we shall go on to solve some more problems so that we can get a hold over this a very important parameter that is used in probability and random processes. Find the expectation of random variable x, which is defined by x is equal to minus 2 with probability 1 by 4, it is equal to 3 with probability 1 by 2, and x is equal to 1 with probability 1 by 4. So I have to find e of x as well as the mean squared value, that is e of x squared. Please note, computing e of x squared is nothing but the mean squared value or the second order moment with n is equal to 2, as we have seen in the first lecture. So I have been given that it is a discrete random variable because I have been only given three values, and clearly it is DRV itself. So write down the data in a mathematical format. So I shall take I shall write a table here, I, xi, p of xi. Or I can take k, xk, p of xk also, not an issue, right? So following the notation as per the ones that have been given here, so I, xi and p of xi. So I shall take I is equal to 1, 2, 3, because how many events have been given with respect to x? Only 3. So that's why I is equal to 1, 2, 3 is there. So if I take x1 is equal to minus 2, then the given probability p of x1 is equal to 1 by 4. That is the probability of occurrence of x1 equal to minus 2 is 1 by 4. That is what is the meaning of the statement. Then let me take I is equal to 2. So xi, that is if I is equal to 2, x2 is equal to 3. And probability of the occurrence of x is equal to x2, that is probability of x2, is simply given by half. Then let me take I is equal to 3. So if I take I is equal to 3, then xi, that is x3, at I is equal to 3 is 1. So P of x3 is simply given by 1 by 4. Use the formula and get the result. So here, how many events are there? 3 events are there. So that's why I is equal to 1 to n. So number of events, n is equal to 3. So that's why expected value E of x is r mu x or mx mean is simply given by summation I is equal to 1 to n xi into P of xi r. That becomes summation I is equal to 1 to 3. Xi into P of Xi. So expand the summation. I get X1 into P of X1 plus X2 into P of X2 plus X3 into P of X3. So it would be minus 2 into 1 by 4, which I have written, which is shown here, plus 3 into half plus 1 into 1 by 4. Simplify, I get 5 by 4 equal to 1.25. Mean squared value or X bar squared are the mean squared value or the second order moment is simply given by E of X squared equal to summation I is equal to 1 to N xi squared into p of xi, n is equal to 3. So I get summation n is I is equal to 1 to 3 xi squared into p of xi. So I have to square only the xi values, not the probability. Don't square the probability values. This I had told in the previous video also. So this becomes x1 squared into p of x1 plus x2 squared into p of x2 plus x3 squared into p of x3. So I get minus 2 the whole squared into 1 by 4 plus 3 squared into 1 by 2 as shown here, plus 1 squared into 1 by 4. So simplify, I get 23 by 4. So this completes the solution of the simple problem. Then we shall go for the computation of the mean and variance of a Bernoulli distribution. This problem we had solved previously in the previous videos, especially L5 lectures. Okay. So in Bernoulli's trials, there are two events. Event A success has the probability P. Event A bar failure has the probability Q is equal to 1 by P. So he asks us to calculate the mean squared value and variance for this Bernoulli's trials. Assume X of A is equal to 1 and X of A bar is equal to 0 to be assigned values to random variables it has. Means in Bernoulli distribution is a discrete distribution. It's one of the most elementary basic discrete distribution. It tells that there are two events, either success or failure. Success, the probability of being success is denoted as P. So event A is the event A denotes success, and the probability of event A happening or probability of success is given as P. I am telling what has been given in the problem. I am not telling anything new. Then the probability of failure is corresponds to probability of event A bar. So that is having a probability of Q is equal to 1 minus P, right? So please note, the sum of the all the events of a discrete distribution should be equal to 1. So by formula, q is equal to 1 minus p. Or if I transpose minus p to the left hand side, I get p plus q is equal to 1, obviously. Right? So p plus q is equal to 1, or q is equal to 1 minus p, or p is equal to 1 minus q. Right? And apart from that, the count of x of a is given to be 1, and the count of a bar, that is x of a bar, is equal to 0. So I should find the mean. So your mean is given by summation I is equal to 1 to n xi into p of xi, or px of xi. There are only two events here. So n would be equal to 2. So directly expanding the events, I get x1 into p of x1 plus x2 into p of x2. Right? Let me write it. I think that would become more clearer. So summation I is equal to 1 to 2 into p of xi okay. So that's what I have written here, because n is equal to because n is equal to 2 and this is I. Okay. So x1 into p of x1 plus x2 into p of x2 I get. So this becomes x1 into p of x1 plus so this is equal to summation I is equal to 1 to 2 xi into p of xi expand. So x1 into p of x1 plus x2 into p of x2 I have. And now x1 is equal to a p of x1 is equal to p of a. This is comma. X1 is equal to a1, so p of x1 is equal to p of a. P of x2 is equal to a bar. X1 is equal to a, sorry, it's not a1. X1 is equal to A. So this is comma. Okay. So P of X1 is equal to P of A. X2 is equal to A bar. So P of X2 is equal to A bar. So substitute here. So I get A into P of A plus A bar into P of A bar. What I have written here, I have substituted here. So P of A is given by 1 by P. P of A bar is given by Q. So A bar happens to be 0. A happens to be 1. So he has given the problem only. So A is equal to 1 A bar is equal to 0. So this is A bar. Okay. So due to this, I get A into P of A plus A bar into P of A bar. So A is 1. A is 1. P of A is P. A bar is 0. P of A bar is Q. So 1 into P plus 0 into Q. So I get P plus 0 equal to P. So this is my mean. Okay. So this is the story of calculating the mean. Next, if I calculate mean, calculating mean squared is very simple. So mean squared value x squared bar is simply given by E of x squared equal to summation is equal to 1 to n xi squared p of xi. So again, for you following the same arguments, it is x1 squared into p of x1 plus x2 squared into p of x2. So x1 is equal to a, x2 is equal to a bar. So that's why I get a squared p of a plus a bar squared into p of a bar is equal to 0. A bar is equal to 0, a is equal to 1. No? That's why this becomes 1 squared into p plus 0 squared into q. R I get p. Now variance is simply given by sigma squared is equal to sigma is equal to 1 to n xi minus mx the whole squared into p of xi r. Expand the summation r. I shall do this in a simple way. This is one approach. I shall do it in a more simpler way. Sigma x squared is given by e of x squared minus mean mx the whole squared or mu x the whole squared. So I get p. E of x squared I have calculated to be equal to p minus mean squared. So mean is also equal to p. So p squared. Now take p common factor. So p into 1 minus 1 minus p is q by data. So this becomes pq. So pq, p into q. So is this not the most simpler method? He has again done some circus here. This method also it's the same answer. As I told previously in the third lecture that there exists many methods, 2 to 3 methods for calculating the variance. But I have followed this more simplest method. So sigma x squared is equal to e of x squared minus mx squared. So that is equal to e of x squared is equal to p. So p minus p squared, that is equal to p into 1 minus p. I take the common factor as p. So 1 minus p is q by data. He has given in the problem statement only. So pq. That's all. This gives me my variance. Standard deviation. Sigma x is simply given by square root of variance. So square root of pq. This completes the solution of the problem. Is it not easy? It's quite easy, right? So I have done he has done a circus here for calculating the variance, whereas I have used a very simple approach. I have just substituted e of x squared minus mean squared, which we have calculated. That's all. Simplify, get the answer within 2-3 lines. This is very, very important. Normally questions are asked on this for derivations and other such criteria. So please be careful. Okay, then we shall go on to the next problem. This is very, very important. This is called a Laplace distribution. This is a normal Laplace distribution. General Laplace distribution is there that we shall discuss in the following lectures to come. This is a very, very important problem. The PDF of a CRV is said to have Laplace distribution given by fx of x is equal to half into e to the power of minus mod of x. This is called mod of x or absolute of x. For minus infinity less than x less than infinity, find out the mean and variance of the random variable. And here, calculating using the integral calculator, definite integral properties is going to be done exquisitely and exclusively. So please remember the properties, because why I am stressing on properties of definite integral calculus is because if I use the definite integral properties, integration evaluation becomes very, very simple. Otherwise, I have to do the evaluation steps a lot. So for a continuous random variable, mean is simply given by integral minus infinity to plus infinity x fx of x dx. Now substitute the value of e to the power of minus mod x multiplied by half for fx of x into this formula. So I get integral minus infinity to plus infinity x into half into e to the power of minus mod of x dx. I have just substituted this into the definition. Other than that, I am doing nothing. Very, very simple, right? Now here I have got x by 2 into fx e to the power of minus mod x. Now I shall do one substitution here. In the integrand, I have got the integrand x half x into e to the power of minus mod x. Now replace x by minus x. Replace x by minus x. Right? If I replace x by minus x, then I have minus x by 2 into e to the power of minus mod x. Minus, this guy has skipped a step here. Let me write it. If I replace x by minus x here, now let me repeat again. I have just substituted mx is given by integral minus infinity to plus infinity x fx of x dx, which is equal to integral minus infinity to plus infinity x into half into e to the power of minus half, sorry, e to the power of minus mod x dx. X into half into e to the power of minus mod x dx with limits integral minus infinity to plus infinity. Now let me substitute f of x is equal to x by 2 into e to the power of minus mod x. We thought in the present problem, f of x is different from fx of x. In the given problem, in the present problem, f of x is different from fx of x. Please be careful here. Now let me replace x integrand by fx. So I get mx is equal to integral minus infinity to plus infinity f of x dx. Now based upon f of x being an even function or an odd function, the integral can be evaluated very easily. Now I am going to do this. Replace x by minus x. Replace x by minus x in f of x. So this becomes f of minus x is equal to minus x by 2 into e to the power of minus of mod x. Mod of minus x is always equal to x. Mod of a negative number is positive. Mod of a positive number is also positive. So that's why mod of a negative number is a positive number. But here I get minus x by 2 into e to the power of minus of mod x. Mod of minus x is equal to mod x. Mod of minus x is equal to mod x. Mod of minus x is mod x only. Mod of a negative number is positive number. Mod of a positive number is positive number. So this negative, this minus sign remains as it is. This minus sign is not going to be affected by the modulus operation. Now I have got minus x by 2 into e to the power of minus x by 2. Now let me put bracket here. Let me put bracket here. Now try to reconcile with what I have written on the reconcile what I have written corresponding to the terms within the brackets. This is nothing but f of x preceded by minus sign. This is equal to minus f of x. This is minus f of x. So I have f of minus x is equal to minus f of x. Please note, modulus of a negative number is a positive number. Modulus of positive or negative number is a positive number only. So that's why mod of minus x is equal to mod x only. Mod of minus x is mod x only. Mod of minus x is mod x only. Here it is preceded by minus sign. So that preceded minus sign I am writing as it is here. This minus sign is this minus sign. I am writing it as it is here. So I have minus x by 2 exponent minus mod x. So which is nothing but minus of f of x. So f of minus x is exactly equal to minus f of x. So it means it's an odd function. It is an odd function. Okay. So what I have written, that this guy has also shown it here. So this is an odd function. So integral of an odd function evaluated over the period is equal to zero. And I have used, and I am going to use this formula also. Integral minus infinity to infinity f of x dx is equal to 0 if f of x is is odd, and it is equal to 2 into integral 0 to minus infinity to plus infinity f of x dx if f of x is even. So this is 2 into integral minus infinity to plus infinity f of x dx, sorry, 2 into integral 0 to infinity it would become, let me do the correction here. So integral minus infinity to plus infinity f of x dx, this is f of x dx is equal to 0 if f of x is odd, and it is equal to 2 into integral 0 to infinity f of x dx if f of x is even. So in the present criteria, f of minus x is equal to minus f of x. So f of x is odd. So the evaluation of an odd function means it is equal to 0. Since f of x is equal to minus f of x, it means that the given function is odd. Since the function is odd, that's why it means that the integral directly evaluates to 0 by using this property. This property we would have proved in our second POC. The same property we are proving it here. Okay. So the utility of this property helps me in directly writing the final answer without having to bother scratching my head on evaluating it. Okay. So this is 2. If the function was even, then I would have the integral would have reduced to this second case. Whereas here, since it is odd, the integral directly evaluates to 0. So that's why this function reduces to 0. This mean value, this integral, I mean to say, this integral reduces to 0. Okay, so that's the way the properties are used here. Next, going on for the second case, that is calculating the variance. For that, I have to find the mean squared value. Now, that is simply given by e of x squared is equal to integral minus infinity to plus infinity x squared f x of x dx. So that would be integral minus infinity to plus infinity x squared into half of e to the power of minus mod x dx. Now let see what I am going to do here now. I shall do the manipulation here only, but please be careful. Let f of x be equal to x squared by 2 into e to the power of minus mod x. Now, where is it? Yeah, annotation tool. Now, now please look here. Let me assume that f of x is equal to x squared by 2 into e to the power of minus mod x. Let me assume that f of x is equal to x squared into 1 by 2 e to the power of minus mod x. Okay. Let me assume that f of x is equal to x squared by 2 into e to the power of minus mod x. Now, let me replace x by minus x. Let me replace x by minus x. So I get f of minus x is equal to x getting x squared getting replaced by minus x the whole squared. So f of minus x would be equal to minus x the whole squared by 2 into e to the power of minus minus of minus mod x. Now minus x the whole squared is x squared, so I get x squared by 2 only. Again e to the power of minus mod x, so mod of minus x is plus x only. The mod of minus x is mod of plus x. Magnitude of a negative number and a positive number means modulus of a positive number only. So that's why I get mod of minus x also to be equal to I get mod of minus x also to be equal to plus x, mod of plus x also to be equal to plus x only. So that's why I get there is no change in f of minus x. That is, the sign of f of minus x and f of x are one and the same. Let me repeat. Let f of x be equal to x squared by 2 into e to the power of minus mod x. Now replace, assume this to be f of x, replace x by minus x. So if I get, if I replace x by minus x, I get f of minus x is equal to minus x by 2 the whole squared e to the power of minus mod x. Mod of minus x is equal to minus x only. So I get x squared by 2 into e to the power of minus mod x itself. So if I compare this with f of x, I infer that f of minus x is exactly equal to f of x. So in this case, f of x is even. Since f of minus x is exactly equal to f of x, I infer that f of x is even. So in this case, the integral reduces to this criteria. 2, integral minus infinity to plus infinity f of x dx would be reducing to 2 into integral 0 to infinity f of x dx. Okay. So this would be reducing to 2 into integral 0 to infinity f of x dx. So the lower limit gets replaced by 0, upper limit infinity would be there. So 2 into integral 0 to infinity f of x dx only if f of x is even. So that's what I have written here. That what I have told, that's what this guy has also written here. I have shown it in a more elegant way in the here. Please note, this problem is very, very important. Any doubts, please feel free to ask. Okay. So that's why this reduces to 2 into integral 0 to infinity f of x dx. Now again, substitute for f of x. So this becomes 2 into integral 0 to infinity x squared into e to the power of minus mod x dx. 2 and 2 gets cancelled. And in the interval 0 to infinity, e to the power of minus mod x is simply given by e to the power of minus x only. So this becomes integral 0 to infinity e to the power of minus x into x squared dx. So in order to evaluate this, we make use of beta gamma functions. Luckily, this guy has also used gamma function. Otherwise, I have to do integration by parts. That's another headache. Now, recall from the definition of gamma function, which I had done in the theory class in the college, that gamma of n is simply written as integral 0 to infinity x to the power of n minus 1 exponent minus x dx. Okay, so that's why this can be written, this integral can be written as integral 0 to infinity x to the power of 3 minus 1. 2 can be written as 3 minus 1, right? So that's why in terms of beta gamma functions I am writing, so integral 0 to infinity x to the power of 3 minus 1 exponent minus x dx I am writing. So this becomes gamma of 3. So gamma of 3 is simply given by factorial of n minus 1. Gamma of 3 is simply given by factorial of n minus 1. Okay, factorial of n minus 1. So where is it? Let me write it again. He has used another formula. I am using another formula, not an issue. So this is equal to gamma of 3. So this is given by gamma factorial of gamma of 3 minus 1 equal to factorial 2 equal to 2. So I am getting the same answer as what this guy has obtained. Okay. Let me write the another formula here. Gamma of n, which is written as factorial of n minus 1. So this integral evaluates to this. Please note the arrow. So factorial n is equal to 3. So that's why I have gamma of 3, which is equal to factorial of 3 minus 1, which is equal to factorial of 2. So factorial of 2 is simply given by 2. So this completes the evaluation of mean squared value. Now variance is given by E of x squared minus mean squared. Mean has been obtained to be 0. So 2 minus 0 is 2. So the variance of the Laplace distribution here is equal to 2. This is a normal Laplacian distribution. Generalized Laplace distribution is there that we shall take up at a later stage. So this completes the solution of the problem. You can do integration by parts and also and get the answer. Bernoulli's generalized rule of integration by parts and get the answer, not an issue. But both all the answers should match. Next. Okay, next we shall find the mean second moment and standard deviation of x when fx of x is given by a e to the power of minus ax into u of x. He has made a printing mistake here. This is not CDF, it is PDF. Okay, he has given PDF, not this is not CDF. So I should find the mean second moment and standard deviation of x when fx of x is equal to a e to the power of minus ax into u of x. Right, now what is u of x? U of x is equal to 1. It's a unit step function here. It is equal to 1. It's not 10, 1.0. For x greater than or equal to 0 and 0 for x less than 0. So due to this, I can write this as mean mx is equal to e of x equal to integral minus infinity to plus infinity x fx of x dx. Substitute for fx of x. I get integral 0 to infinity x a e to the power of minus ax dx, because u of x is equal to 0 for x less than 0, that's why, and it is having a non-zero amplitude of 1 for x greater than or equal to 0. So this becomes integral 0 to infinity x a e to the power of minus ax dx into 1. So I get x a e to the power of minus ax dx. What is that into 1? Yeah, the u of x value. Okay, so integral 0 to infinity x a e to the power of minus ax into dx I have. Now we shall continue to evaluate this. Now a is a constant, so I can write this as a integral 0 to infinity x e to the power of minus x. Now this can be evaluated using gamma functions also, or I shall use the integration by parts. So integral x e to the power of minus ax dx. So what is integration by parts? Integral u dv is equal to uv minus integral vdu. So if I integrate, take x to be equal to u and dv is equal to e to the power of minus ax. Okay, now this becomes a is a constant, so it remains outside. So x into u integral of the second function, first function into integral of the second function. So x into e to the power of minus ax by minus a, because integral of a exponent ax is exponent ax by a. So a is equal to minus a here. So that's why I get x e to the power of minus ax by minus a. Minus integral of second function. So e to the power of minus ax by minus a into differential of the first function. So d by dx of x. So dx by dx is 1. So I get x e to the power of minus ax by minus a minus integral e to the power of minus ax by minus a into 1 dx. Now substitute. So this becomes x e to the power of minus ax by minus a plus 1 by a into integral e to the power of minus ax, or for the simplification and substitution of the lower and upper limits gives me 1 by a. I hope you are able to do the integration by parts and substitution of the lower and upper limits. So this gives me 1 by a. Any doubts in evaluation, please feel free to ask, because I have done many problems based on this in the theory class. So I hope you would be able to do the simplification. If you have any doubts, please feel free to ask me by WhatsApp or call me or send an email to me. I will definitely revert back to you. So this would give me 1 by a. Now second moment are the I have to find. So x squared bar, it is nothing but the mean squared value, is given by integral minus infinity to plus infinity x squared fx of x dx. Substitute fx of x value, so I get, and also noting that u of x is equal to 0 for x less than 0, I get integral 0 to infinity x squared a to the power of minus ax dx. Now apply integration by parts or beta gamma function or Bernoulli's generalized integration by parts. So I get a into integral 0 to infinity x squared e to the power of minus ax. So how has it done here? I will show the Bernoulli's generalized integration by parts. I think that would be most apt here. First function into integral of second function minus first differential coefficient of first function into second integral into second integral of second function. Next, plus for second order differential of the first function into the third integral of the third function. So I should continue this process until this differential order coefficient of the first function becomes equal to 0, and plus minus it would be oscillating. So it would, I should write this like this: a into x squared, this is x squared into e to the power of minus ax by minus a minus 2x into e to the power of minus ax minus a squared plus 2. Differential coefficient of x is 1, because dx by dx is 1. So e to the power of minus ax by minus a limit 0 to infinity. Now substitute the lower and the upper limits, I get the final answer. So how to do it? If I substitute lower and the upper limits for the first term here, so e to the power of minus infinity is 0, so 0 into anything is 0, and 0 into e to the power of 0 I get if I substitute the lower limit, so 0 minus 0 I get for the this first term. First term evaluates to 0. Now second term, I get minus 2 by a squared into x e to the power of minus ax limit 0 to infinity. Now e to the power of minus infinity into anything is 0 into anything is 0, because if I substitute the upper limit x is equal to infinity here, it would be e to the power of minus infinity. E to the power of minus infinity is 0. 0 into anything is 0. 0 by any number is 0. So this now the upper limit of the second term also comes to 0. Now substitute the lower limit for the second term. 0 into e to the power of 0 is 0 into 1 equal to 0. So there is no contribution from the first and the second terms, because they directly value to 0. I have contribution only from this term, that is the third term. That is 2 by minus a cubed into e to the power of minus ax limit 0 to infinity multiplied by a, of course. So that would come to 2 by a squared, because this a and this minus a cubed gets cancelled. Let me show it properly. this a and this minus a cubed gets cancelled. So I will be having minus 2 by a cubed into e to the power of minus infinity minus e to the power of minus 0. E to the power of minus 0 is 1. So e to the power of minus infinity is 0. So I get minus 2 by a squared into 0 minus 1. So I get 2 by a squared as I have here. Okay, this is much more simpler method for doing the integration. This you would have done it in engineering maths 1, 2, 3 and 4. For now also you would be doing. That I have used the same generalized integration by parts by Bernoulli. So standard deviation is given by square root of e of x squared minus mx squared. So square root of 2 by a squared minus mean has been given by 1 by a. So 1 by a the whole squared is 1 by a squared. So root of 2 by a squared minus 1 by a squared is root of 1 by a squared, which is equal to 1 by a. Okay. So I have shown the this is the standard deviation. 1 by a is the standard deviation. 1 by a squared would be the variance. That's all. Now, this is the simple most method for finding the integration by parts, which I have shown for calculating the mean squared value. I asked you guys only to do the integration for finding the mean. So I hope you would be able to do it. Any doubts, please feel free to ask. We shall continue other lectures in the next class. Okay. Thank you.